creaky forest. Jessie Matthews was sitting in her room reading a book. Well, pretending to read. She was too excited to concentrate on the story. Her best friend, Emily Dean, was coming over for a sleepover, and Jessie couldn't wait. Giving up on reading, Jessie wandered out into the sitting room, pretending she wasn't waiting for the doorbell to ring. After what seemed like an eternity, the doorbell rang. Jessie jumped from her chair and bolted for the door. She threw it open, and there was Emily. Emily dropped her bags and threw her arms around Jessie. They jumped and squealed. When the hug ended, Jessie shoved a list of things she had planned into Emily's hands. "This is a list of everything we're going to do during our sleepover," Jessie said, smiling. Jessie was very organized and liked to plan ahead. "Wow," Emily said, reading the list. "That's a lot of stuff." Emily smiled as she turned the list over and read the back. "But we can do it all, although I'm not sure about number 24. Meet the new neighbors? I don't think I could do that." Emily was super shy until you got to know her. Jessie giggled. "Okay, we could skip that one. Let's go to my room and set up your bed." After setting up Emily's bed, she and Jessie started the activities. Bracelet making, playing board games and makeovers. Finally, they got to number 13, a walk in the woods behind Jessie's house. "Shouldn't we skip number 13, Emily said, looking at the list. "Why?" said Jessie. "You've been in the woods before and you weren't scared." Emily bit her lip. "Yeah, but 13 is an unlucky number." Emily had always been very superstitious. Ever since kindergarten, when Timmy Johnson opened an umbrella inside and broke his arm a day later. "Say, doesn't your grandmother live on 13 Main Street? And isn't your sister 13 years old?" "Has anything happened to them?" Jessie said with a grin. At this, Emily smiled. "Good point," she said. Emily tugged her straight red hair into a ponytail, and Jessie perched a baseball cap atop her sandy curls. "Come on," Jessie said, pulling Emily out the door and into the woods. They walked for a few minutes through the woods, talking and laughing and pointing out interesting things they saw. A squirrel gathering nuts, a bright yellow butterfly, a glowing flower. "Wait a minute," Jessie said, walking up to the flower. "Is it glowing?" Emily followed her. "Yeah, I think it is." Emily poked the flower, and it stopped glowing. The ground began to shake. "Earthquake!" Jessie screamed, bolting back to the house with Emily on her tail. Earthquakes weren't common here, but the girls knew that it was dangerous to be outside during one. They had barely made it halfway back to the house when the ground gave way beneath their feet, and they were plunged into total darkness. Jessie felt herself falling. Emily let out a scream, but it was swept away as soon as it left her mouth. After what seemed like an eternity, they landed with a thud. Jessie stood up and brushed herself off and helped Emily. They looked around. It looked exactly like the forest near Jessie's house, but it was different. There was an eerie silence and a creepy chill in the air. The girls shivered. "Look," said Emily, pointing to the ground. Underneath their feet was a large, flat stone. "Someone wrote on this stone." Jessie looked down. "Escape before midnight or stay forever," she read aloud. Jessie turned to Emily. "I knew this wasn't Jessie's woods," Emily muttered under her breath, then looked back at Jessie. "So it seems like some kind of netherworld," Emily finally said. "And we have to escape or we'll be stuck here forever and before midnight." "But how do we escape?" Jessie wailed, sinking to the ground. "How do we even know we'll make it out alive? Or make it out at all, for that matter," she pouted. "Oh, come on, Jessie, please don't say things like that. Think positive," Emily said, pulling Jessie onto her feet. "There must be some clues somewhere." she began walking farther into the forest. Jesse nodded and started after her. That makes sense. In all the mystery novels I've read, there's always clues. I guess this isn't much different, Jesse said once she caught up to Emily. What time is it? Emily asked Jesse, who always wore a watch. 6 p.m. We have 6 hours left until midnight. Determined to escape, they set off on their adventure. Thud! What was that noise? Jesse asked. Her voice trembled. Her stomach lurched. Her eyes were as big as saucers. Thud! I heard it too, said Emily, turning around to survey the land around them. She went pale. Thud! Neither of the girls knew what dangers were in the forest, and they didn't want to find out. Thud! They heard rustling coming from the trees behind them. Whatever was coming was very close. Thud! A giant spider emerged from the trees. It had huge, hairy legs, its teeth were sharp as daggers, and it had 8 huge eyes. 8 eyes that were black as night and seemed to stare into your soul. Terrified, the girls screamed and ran. The spider chased after them, screeching and groaning. It chased the girls into a dark cave filled with cobwebs covered in dead bugs. The girls were concerned, cornered in the spider's lair. Emily wasn't used to running this much. She gulped in air. Exhausted, she leaned against the ivory-covered wall behind them and almost fell through. Jesse, she whispered, this wall is made entirely of ivy. We can escape through it. The spider was closing in on them, ready to add them to its web of victims. Okay, Jesse said. Stay as quiet as you can. I got this. Jesse faced the spider, looked it dead in the eye, and started yelling. Hey, spider, 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 she yelled. Here, spider, spider, spider. Then she took off her baseball cap and threw it as far as she could out of the cave. The spider chased after it, and the girls escaped through the back. They ran like never before, but the spider caught up with them in no time, only momentarily fooled by the baseball cap. After running for what seemed like forever, they ended up running near the edge of a cliff. Emily! Jesse shouted over her shoulder. Now's the perfect time. Let's knock it off the cliff. Emily nodded, took her hair down, and slingshotted the elastic band into the brush. The spider started after it, but turned back to them almost immediately. This still gave them enough time to get a huge branch from the ground. Together, they swung the branch like a huge baseball bat and knocked the spider over the cliff to the ground below. As Jesse and Emily cheered in celebration, Emily tripped over a rock. She stumbled to the edge of the cliff and fell, falling to the ground below where the hungry spider was waiting, falling to her doom. Emily! Screamed Jesse, sprinting over to the edge. She peered over the edge, afraid of what she might see. And there was Emily, not being devoured by the spider, not laying in a heap on the ground, but hanging onto the edge of the cliff. Help, please! Pull me up, please! She gasped. Jesse grabbed her hand and pulled her back up. Thanks, Emily said, sinking to the ground. Jesse looked up. She gulped. Don't rest yet. Look! Behind Emily stood the spider, which had scaled the cliff while Jesse was helping Emily. Run! With the spider in pursuit, the girls ran deeper into the forest. After running for what seemed like forever, they fell. Jesse's stomach dropped and Emily let out a yelp. They were trapped in a huge, deep pit. They couldn't escape. 30 huge spiders dropped into the pit with them, but nothing was as terrifying as the time. 11:59 p.m. 1 minute until midnight, shrieked Jesse. The spiders were closing in on them. Their hairy legs crept, their dagger-like teeth gleamed, and 240 eyes watched their every move. The spiders were inches away. Time stood still. Oddly, for a second during their impending doom, Emily wondered whether the spiders would take turns or fight with each other to suck the lifeblood out of their frail, trembling bodies. "Look!" whispered Emily, tugging on Jesse's sleeve. She was pointing at something. "Emily, we..." started Jesse. But then she saw where Emily was pointing. It was a glowing flower. Together, they touched the flower, just as Jesse's watch struck midnight. They were laying on the ground in the middle of the woods behind Jesse's house. The sun was shining, the birds were singing, and they were alive. No time had passed since they had left. Emily stood up.
We made it, she said, looking around.
Jesse stood up too. The girls whooped and cheered in celebration. After a series of hugs, they walked back to Jesse's house, feeling exhausted. I'm starving, said Emily, picking twigs from her hair and wiping blood from her face. I agree. Let's order a pizza, Jesse responded as she brushed dirt from her face and tried to straighten her clothes. When they reached the house, Jesse opened the door. And there, standing in the doorway, was a giant spider. With huge, hairy legs, and teeth sharp as daggers, with eight eyes that were black as night, and seemed to stare into their soul. The end.